Anyway, I'm just going to welcome you all to the EFT, Law of Attraction, workshop for manifesting abundance, success, prosperity, and all kinds of good things. And my name's Tony Parker, and I got my good friends Tammy and William on, and hopefully some other people will trickle in. But as we normally do, we start off with a series of warm-ups, warm-up taps, and then we'll get into personal issues, goals, challenges, successes, victories, all that good stuff. So let's start off with the first tap, which is the protective shield of golden light. Again, it's really easy. We just start off tapping with the top of our head. And again, Simon says, repeat after me, okay. Energy system.
Energy system.
Okay, now tapping on the eyebrows. I'm instructing you.
I'm instructing you.
Okay, side of the eye. To generate a protective shield of golden light.
To generate a protective shield of golden light.
Okay, now on the cheekbone, under the eyes, all around my body.
All around my body.
Under the nose, protecting me from all negative energies.
Protecting me from all negative energies.
Okay, under the mouth, all negative influences.
All negative influences.
Okay, collarbone, all negative intentions.
All negative intentions.
Okay, under the arm, all negative entities.
All negative entities.
Karate chop, sending them all to the sun.
Sending them all to the sun.
To be transmuted to love.
To be transmuted to love.
Okay, top of the head, only allowing in.
Only allowing in.
Eyebrow, loving.
Loving.
Side of the eye, healing.
Healing.
Under the eye, positive.
Positive.
Under the nose, energies.
Energies.
Under the mouth, and intentions.
And intentions.
Very good. Excellent. Collarbone. And if I have any negative energies or intentions?
And if I have any negative energies or intentions.
Okay, under the arm. I send them all to the sun.
I send them all to the sun.
Karate chop to be transmuted to love.
To be transmuted to love.
Beautiful. Let's all take a deep breath. And now release. Okay, excellent. And now we're going to move on to the Ho'oponopono tap, which is a great exercise, great tap, great practice. There's a lot of discussion on the internet on Ho'oponopono. It's been around for a long, 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 long time. Native Hawaiians have been practicing it for gazillions of years, of course. And it's recently resurfaced, and a lot of people are discussing it on the internet. Of course, we're going to do it in English, and we're going to combine it with EFT, which makes it really awesome. So let's just start tapping on the top of the head and just repeat after me. Okay, Simon says, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
Eyebrow, please forgive me.
Please forgive me.
Okay, side of the eye, I forgive you.
I forgive you.
Cheekbone under the eye, I forgive myself.
I forgive myself.
Under the nose, thank you.
Thank you.
Under the mouth, I love you.
I love you.
Collarbone, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
Under the arm, please forgive me.
Please forgive me.
Karate chop, I forgive you.
I forgive you.
Top of the head, I forgive myself.
I forgive myself.
Eyebrow, thank you.
Thank you.
Side of the eye, I love you.
I love you.
Under the eye, I'm sorry.
I'm sorry.
Under the nose, please forgive me.
Please forgive me.
Under the mouth, I forgive you.
I forgive you.
Collarbone, I forgive myself.
I forgive myself.
Under the arm, thank you.
Thank you.
Karate chop, I love you. There you go.
I love you.
Excellent. Very good. Let's all take a deep breath. And now release. That was good. I heard some releasing going on there. That's good. Okay, so now we're going to move along to our gratitude tap. And the first version of the gratitude tap we're going to do is what just kind of general all-around gratitude tap, which is pretty much what they do with those $3,000 you know, law of attraction weekend seminars and at the Hotel Marriott, you know, before they send you home on Sunday night, they say, make a list of 10 things you're grateful for and tabity, tabity, tabity. So you guys want to check in? Who wants to check in with something, generally speaking, something that happened maybe over the last 7 days or an aspect or an event or a person or something you're grateful for and feel positive about that we can tap on together? Go ahead, please.
I will. It's Tammy, and I seem to have landed a lovely job.
Woohoo! Woohoo! Cool. Awesome. Top of the head. Awesome. Very cool. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Eyebrow. Thank you.
Thank you.
Side of the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the nose. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the mouth. Thank you.
Thank you.
Collarbone. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the arm. Thank you.
Thank you.
Karate chop. Thank you.
Thank you.
Excellent. Let's all take a deep breath. Inhale, release. Okay. Very good. Excellent. Ooh. And then, Willem, something you're grateful for?
I am grateful for having this nice cold weather that keeps the roads dry instead of slick and dangerous.
Well, I hear you. Okay, top of the head. Thank you.
Thank you.
Eyebrow. Thank you.
Thank you.
Side of the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the nose. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the mouth, thank you.
Thank you.
Collarbone, thank you.
Thank you.
Under the arm, thank you.
Thank you.
Karate chop, thank you.
Thank you.
Take a deep breath and I'll release. Okay. There you go. That's nice. Okay, I'll share that. Friday I hung out with one of my buddies. We just kind of had a guy's afternoon. We went shopping at Lowe's and got guy stuff. and what's the name of the other place? Home Depot, right? Is it Home Depot or what's is that?
Yeah.
The other guy's store, right? And we bought wrenches and nuts and bolts and hinges and, you know, all that good guy stuff. Top of that. Thank you. Yeah, it was fun.
Boys,
shopping trip, right? No frilly, girly, whirly stuff. Top of that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Eyebrow. Thank you.
Thank you.
Side of the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yeah, thank you.
Thank you.
Under the nose, thank you.
Thank you.
Under the mouth, thank you.
Thank you.
Collarbone, thank you.
Thank you.
Under the arm, thank you.
Thank you.
Karate chop, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, take a deep breath. And I'll release. Very cool. Excellent. All right, let's go to cash and prizes. Yeah. And share a source of income. This can be an employer, an agency, a client, customer, anybody who's been a source of abundance or any organization that's been a source of abundance that you'd like to raise up and express gratitude to. So take it away, guys. Go ahead.
Are we doing initials, Tony?
If you want initials, that's fine, or first names. I mean, this is going to be, I'm going to record this. So this will be, what I do with this is the personal stuff I don't record, the public, you know, these, the warm-ups I do, you know what I mean?
Okay, sure.
Go ahead.
Okay, I would say LC.
Okay, top of the head. Thank you.
Thank you.
Eyebrow, thank you.
Thank you.
Side of the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the nose. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the mouth. Thank you.
Thank Thank you.
Collarbone. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the arm. Thank you.
Thank you.
Karate chop. Thank you.
Thank you.
Excellent. Very good. Let's all take a deep breath. And I'll release. Very cool. All right. William, source of abundance in your life. Go ahead, please.
Yeah, I would like to be thankful for my job. I just got informed that as of January 1st, I get a small raise that'll be effective as of January 1st.
Awesome. Very cool. Top of the head. Thank you.
Thank you.
Eyebrow. Thank you.
Thank you.
Side of the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the nose. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the mouth. Thank you.
Thank you.
Collarbone. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the arm. Thank you.
Thank you.
Karate chop. Thank you.
Thank you.
Excellent.
Thank you.
Very good. Excellent. Let's all take a deep breath. And I'll release. Okay. And now JB. Okay. Top of the head. Thank you.
Thank you.
Eyebrow. Thank you.
Thank you.
Side of the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the nose. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the mouth. Thank you.
Thank you.
Collarbone. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the arm. Thank you.
Thank you.
Karate chop. Thank you.
Thank you.
Excellent. Very good. Let's all take a deep breath. And I'll release. Okay. Very good. And now we're going to move along to the love tap. And there's two ways it works. Is if you're in an existing relationship, share an aspect of your partner that you love, admire, are grateful for. Or if you're shopping, like moi, you bring up the initials, names of past loves, and et cetera. So, you guys, Tammy, who wants to go first?
I'll go first. Okay. I would just like to express gratitude for how gentle William is. He's a true gentle spirit.
Oh, mushy, squishy. Okay, cool. All right. Thank you. Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, eyebrow. Thank you.
Thank you.
Side of the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the nose. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the mouth. Thank you.
Thank you.
Collarbone. Thank you.
Thank you.
Under the arm. Thank you.
Thank you.
Karate chop. Thank you.
Thank you.
Excellent. So I'll take a deep breath and I'll release. Very cool. And William, something you'd like to share. Go ahead, please.
I'd like to share that I'm grateful for Tammy's hustle and her drive to become employed again, and how hard she's worked at trying to make that happen for herself.
Awesome. Very cool. Top of the head. Thank you.
Thank you.
Eyebrow, thank you.
Thank you.
Side of the eye, thank you.
Thank you.
Under the eye, thank you.
Thank you.
Under the nose, thank you.
Thank you.
Under the mouth, thank you.
Thank you.
Collarbone, thank you.
Thank you.
Karate chop, thank you.
Thank you.
Excellent. Take a deep breath. And I'll release. That's funny. Today I was thinking about an old flame, a woman I dated probably about 30, oh, you don't want to know how many years ago, but you know, you start thinking about somebody, you know, and I mean, I'm sure she's still around, but it's been a long time. But anyway, DM, top of the head. Thank you.
Thank you.
Eyebrow. Thank you.
Thank you.
Side of the eye. Thank you.
Thank you.
And I thank you.
Thank you.
One of the nose, thank you.
Thank you.
One of the mouth, thank you.
Thank you.
Collarbone, thank you.
Thank you.
Under the arm, thank you.
Thank you.
Karate chop, thank you.
Thank you.
Take a deep breath, and I'll release. Yeah, I'll tell you, just to get you an idea how long, I mean, if we'd have had children, they'd be over 30 years old. That's an old flame. Anyway, why not? It was still fun when it was, listen, we enjoyed each other tremendously, but I guess like all things. But anyway, so let's do the money tap, okay? And I guess we can do, since a bunch of us will do the kind of the vague form of the money tap, okay? But if you're doing it on your own, you want to use the real money, okay? But again, rubbing sore spot or tapping on your karate chop, okay? Just repeat after me, okay, Simon says. Even though I made what I made last month.
Even though I made what I made last month.
I choose to make twice what I made last month this month.
I choose to make twice what I made last month this month.
And I deeply and completely love, accept, and forgive myself.
Love, accept, and forgive myself.
Very good. So even though I made what I made last month.
Even though I made what I made last month.
I set a firm intention. To make twice what I made last month this month.
Make twice what I made last month this month.
And I deeply and completely. Love, accept, and forgive myself. Beautiful. So even though I made what I made last month.
Even though I made what I made last month.
Today, right now, I set a firm intention.
Today, right now, I set a firm intention.
To make twice what I made last month this month. And I deeply and completely. Love, accept, and forgive myself. Very good. Excellent. Let's go top of the head. I choose to make twice what I made last month this month.
I deserve to make twice what I made last month this month.
I give myself permission to make twice what I made last month this month. Excellent. Cheekbone under the eye. I am willing to make twice what I made last month this month.
I'm willing to make twice what I made last month this month.
Okay, under the nose. It's safe for me to make twice what I made last month this month. Okay, under the mouth. I have the power to make twice what I made last month this month.
I have the power to make twice what I made last month this month.
Collarbone. I like the way it feels when I make twice what I made last month this month.
I like the way it feels when I make twice what I made last month this month.
Okay, under the arm. It's easy for me to make twice what I made last month this month.
It's easy for me to make twice what I made last month this month.
Karate chop. So even though I made what I made last month.
Even though I made what I made last month.
Today, right now, I set a firm intention. To make twice what I made last month this month. And I deeply and completely. Love, accept, and forgive myself. Excellent. So I'll take a deep breath. And now release. Okay, very good. All right, so there you go. That's our little warm-up series. And now it's time for check-in. Again, synchronicities, challenges, victories, kvetch or kvel. Okay, who wants to check in, please? Go ahead.
What's Tammy? I'll start.
Okay, go ahead. Sounds like good news. Go ahead.
So I had a a friend or a former colleague and former schoolmate that recommended I check into a certain counseling agency close by in the same town that I had been working in, and I applied for a adult rehabilitative mental health service, like in-home worker. Mm-hmm. And since I was doing in-home before, and I have a pretty good reputation and came highly recommended, I had a meeting with the two people that own this agency, and they were thrilled to have me on, and they were going to call my professional references. And once that was done, they'd get the paperwork together, and I could start working in January, like on January 3rd. And what's super cool about that is that's really the same week that my unemployment runs out. So we had been hoping and shooting for me kind of Tarzan swing right into the next great thing. And the thing that's really notable about this is that when I had written out my perfect job movie script a couple of years ago when I first started this, when I was starting to identify the real problem areas of where I was working, this place has a lot of those things that I had been hoping for, you know, healthy people, a lot of support, a nurturing environment. You know, the state sends other agencies to them to learn how they run their program because they have such a high retention rate of employees that they have a solid group of 10 people that are doing this, and they don't have any turnover. So that's really pretty remarkable, and what a great place to land considering where I came from. So all of that is just beautiful, and I'm deliriously happy about it. So
awesome. Well, so, I mean, it sounds wonder. I mean, you know, exactly what you wanted. And it's a sort of, shall we say, a better class of client or upmarket in terms of the clientele or whatever you want to call it, or less of an ACOA reenactment kind of thing.
Right. Well, these are all people who want help, every single one of them. So
you're not fighting them. You're not fighting.
No.
Good.
No. So I'm excited about getting started doing that. And I'm, of course, you know, relieved about having gainful employment. And I'm thrilled about that. And
that's awesome. Good for you. Take a bow. Yeah. Take a bow. Yay. Tammy.
Woohoo. Yay. No applause, just throw money.
just throw money. Yeah, cool. Yeah. Awesome. Well, I'm glad to hear it. And like I said, you know, as Paulie used to say, this shit really works. Okay.
Yeah, right. Right on. Yeah.
Okay. And William, how are we doing? You want to check in? Anything you want to check in for or with about?
I'm really excited about getting the raise.
That's good.
I found that out at the meeting, yeah. Mm-hmm. It's actually going to mean several thousand dollars at the end of the year.
That's nice.
Yes, it is. And so I'm really excited about that. Mm-hmm. That means a big deal. More money to go play with.
Awesome. Well, that's good. And great. Sounds like some real progress. You know, things are going. Now, I'm kind of remembering from last week, okay, you were gestating other ways of making money, kind of looking for inspiration and kind of guidance. Have you had any kind of inspirations or anything kind of floating through?
Yes, I have. I've got one little dream. I've been trying to find the perfect plot of land to move Tammy and I to, and I'd like to find a spot where I can set up about five rustic campsites where it's all, we set up wall tents and then have people come to visit. Mm-hmm. And basically all you do is pack your bag and show up. Everything's there for you. Mm-hmm. It's all supply, everything. And that's what I'd like to do. I'd like to look at that.
Awesome. Well, there you go. Kind of like a rustic bed and breakfast or something, or maybe not quite.
Yeah.
Cool.
Yeah, well, it'd be something like that. I mean, obviously, you know, set it up for weekend rates or, newly married couples, nice little, I'd like to get someplace that's kind of off the beaten path. So you get a real deep woods experience. It's just something set up where there's hiking trails, fishing, all that stuff right there available for you. And all you do is, instead of having a cabin, you show up and you rough it a little bit in a wall tent and a hand pump and maybe an outside clawfoot tub and just have a grand time.
Cool. Awesome. Well, it's good that you're getting kind of inspirations and kind of, that's the whole point about this, is it to kind of develop the inspirations. And then, you know, once you've got the kind of the general inspiration, then you start to work on the vision or the, you know, and it's interesting how the details start to fill in. And then once you get the details, then you get these weird little synchronicities and coincidences of bumping into people who kind of want to help you along the way and, you know, et cetera, or somebody who's going to offer you the land or whatever, you know. That's the amazing thing about this work. When we start to get into it, you're going to start seeing some really funny little weird little coincidences, you know, helping you along, you know. That's cool. Awesome. Okay, cool. By the way, Tammy, we didn't get into anything you want to tap on tonight. Is there anything you want to tap on specifically, or where are we tapping wise?
You know, I'm thrilled about the job. I want to make sure that I'm, I think, really just prepared to go back to work. I don't know that I have anything. I've been working on my money thermostat. I don't think that I have, nothing's come up, but I would like to sift through and see if I have any limiting beliefs or if I have, I know last week when we got done with the call, I wrote down that, you know, I can't get a job that pays what I used to make because I never got my degree. And I tapped on that through the week. And the first thing the woman said to me when I went in for my interview was, she said, "Now, do you have a degree?" I said, "No, I never completed my degree." She goes, "Well, don't worry, you don't need one." So I was like, "Whoo!" Took care of that right away. And I'm actually going to get paid a couple dollars an hour more than I had been making. But again, it's, you know, direct client contact phase. So it's, you're kind of, you know how that goes. So, so right now I really don't have anything, but, you know, I don't know if William has something that he wants to work on or if you want to lead away.
I'm interested. William, I just want, cause I kind of jumped over to William and I just wanted to get back, make sure we didn't miss you, you know, that's all.
Yeah.
Okay, William, where do you want to go with your tapping, William?
I want to work on some more on the money thermostat, and I would like to, I mean, I basically quit talking to my parents about any of my ideas because they keep coming up with reasons why I shouldn't do this and shouldn't do that, such as like the campsite idea I did years ago, and they just, well, you don't want to deal with people. Well, you know, I don't want to hear that because I've read several articles where there's people making a good living actually providing wild wilderness experiences for people. And that's what I'd like to do.
Absolutely. Well, why not? And again, you know, the family vows and the family myths and legends and the family scripts, that's definitely the area that, you know, it comes up with everything, of course, but definitely comes up when it's around abundance, money, and success, you know, and depending on what our family's attitudes were around money or behaviors were around, depending how crazy they were, you know, it's going to have some kind of an impact on us. And, you know, it's especially if you start hearing these negative voices or, shall we say, the echoes of your family's negative voices, you know. So why don't we tune into who was the biggest naysayer in your family whenever you would come up with a bright idea?
I'd say it was mostly my dad.
Okay.
When I felt it was a brilliant idea.
Okay.
When I felt there was something that I was going to hit on that would, you know, possibly make me quite a source of income, regardless of how I get there, it was always negative.
And he'd kind of shoot it down.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Okay, so what I want you to do is we're going to do a couple of things, okay? Maybe we'll turn it into a movie technique or, you know, but why don't we just get in touch with that kind of naysaying negative energy, right? And when you think about it right now, okay, I just want you to tune into it, and maybe you can even picture a time or a moment. You said you had brought this up, the campsite idea, to your father at one time a bunch of years back, right? Is it correct?
Yes, right.
Okay.
Yes.
And he just shot you down. And how did that feel? And where did you feel it? Let's connect with all that, okay?
Yeah. I feel it in my sore spot.
Okay.
Yeah. And I feel let down and not listened to.
Okay. You know? All right. And on a scale of 0 to 10 right now that we're connecting with that moment, what would be the level of intensity?
About a 7.
Okay. So even though I've got this letdown feeling.
Even though I have this letdown feeling.
Disappointed.
Disappointed.
Shot down.
Shot down.
And whenever I brought anything up to my father.
Whenever I brought anything up to my father.
A brilliant idea. He'd just shoot it right down. And then I'd get all disappointed and let down.
And I would get all disappointed and let down.
But I deeply and completely love, accept, and forgive myself.
Love and accept and forgive myself.
And let me ask you, and what would happen then? Would you just kind of give up? Is that what would happen? You'd kind of give up and despair?
I would kind of not decide to chase it because it, you know, they'd come up with sometimes somewhat convincing, but mostly reasons why I shouldn't do it. You know, like, oh, you don't want to deal with all that kind of people or you know, always some kind of excuse why you shouldn't do it instead of reasons why you should.
Right. So, and then it would kind of just kill your idea before it even got off the ground and you just give up. And okay. So even though I go to my parents with a great idea.
Even though I go to my parents with a great idea.
I go to particularly my father. And he'd come up with a million reasons why I couldn't do something. And I just give up. And I just feel let down. But I deeply and completely. Love, accept, and forgive myself.
Love and accept and forgive myself.
Okay, top of the head. He always shot me down.
Yeah, he always shot me down.
Eyebrow, no matter what it was. And he always had a million reasons why it wouldn't work. And then I just give up. Because what did I know? And I gave my father so much power. And then I'd feel all let down and despairing. And I just give up under the arm. I just give up. But today I'm taking my power back from my father. Okay, top of that. It was just his opinion. Eyebrow, and he was no financial genius.
Sigh
of the eye. And what did he know?
And what did he know?
Under the eye. But silly me, I believed him.
But silly me, I believe.
I don't know. So I gave him all that power. But that's not working for me anymore. Gollibon, I'm taking my power back from my father.
I'm taking my power back from my father.
Under the arm. I mean, it's just an opinion.
It's just an opinion.
Karate chapter. You know what they say about opinions. Top of the head. Everybody's got one. And my father's definitely not a financial genius. And just because I gave him all that power when I was younger. I'm taking my power back from my father. Because he doesn't deserve my power. Under the mouth. Nobody deserves my power. But silly me. I thought if I gave my father my all my power, he'd love me.
Under the arm,
giving my father all my power didn't change anything. Karate chop. So today I've learned something. I've learned a thing or two in the last few years. I don't have to give anybody my power. Top of the head, I don't have to give my father my power. I don't have to give my mother my power. I don't have to give anybody my power. My power belongs to me. And if I want to do something? It's up to me to decide whether I want to do it or not. And I can do this camping thing. And I don't need my father's approval in order to do it. Karate chop. So even though I thought I needed my father's approval to do anything when I was younger. Today, right now, I realize I don't need my father's approval for anything. Because I deeply and completely. Love, accept, and forgive myself. Okay, take a deep breath. And now release. Okay, how does that feel?
It feels pretty good.
Okay, I mean, those are those old family tapes, you know, and they really do affect our decisions, and it can really affect our financial decisions. It's amazing when you think about it, you know. And again, it's a kind of like a little program or a virus, you know, that was planted there. And I mean, you know, let's put it this way. You know, we get these ideas or these beliefs, you know, initially with good intentions, you know what I mean? If they hold us back, then it's time to change the program. It's time to change the tape. And, you know, as you said, you know, listen, you're a fully grown man. You know, your father has an opinion just like everybody else. And, you have an opinion, you know, but it's your life. So your opinion's more important than anybody else's. You know what I mean? If it's your life, but of course it takes a while to figure that out. Well, you know, cause as ACOAs, we're always kind of somebody, you know, like I said, we have to change a few scripts, you know what I mean?
Right.
You know, But definitely, you know, if there's doubts, if you have lingering doubts like that or those kind of hidden little gotchas, that's definitely the stuff to tap on. And if you figure, if you, you know, you catch them. An interesting thing is they usually don't come up until you try and do something. In other words, usually those hidden voices, I call it the shitty committee, you know, usually they stay pretty silent until you try and do something. And the minute you try, and that's when they come out. You know, you can't do that. You don't know what you're doing. What are you? You don't like people. You know what I mean? All that craziness, you know. But that's write them down, because that's EFT gold. That's tapping gold, you know. So, again, it's, you know, even though I had this misbelief that I'm not good with people or whatever, you know, whatever it is your father said, I'd write down those sentences that he would say. Mm-hmm. You know, and then just work on those, just tap on them. And, you know, we can tap on them some more, you know, at another session if you want. But that's okay. EFT gold. That's a, I mean, do you remember, you know, this was publicly discussed. So it's not talking out of school, but do you remember, Tammy, when Paulie would talk about his mother saying, yeah, you know, all businessmen are thieves, all salesmen are crooks. And then
all salesmen are crooks.
Right. He was a salesman, so he'd walk in to close a deal and he'd sabotage himself because he was being loyal to his mother, you know, and her script, or, you know, the family vow that he has to be on, you know, he has to be loyal to his mother. So, you know, he'd mess it up. He'd blow it.
Right.
You know, snatching defeat from the jaws of victory. So that's right. You know, so that's kind of why it's important to work on this stuff. So, like I said, when you remember that voice and the sentence that your father, just write them down, and then we'll go back and we'll do the, even though, you know, my father said, blah, 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 you know, you don't want to be dealing with people, you know, da, 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 deeply, you know, it's not true. Right. I can relate to people just fine. You know, that was just my father's opinion. You know, I know how to relate to people. Maybe he couldn't relate to people, you know?
Right.
You know, and then we tap on all that stuff, because that's EFT gold when you start, and it stays silent for years until you try and do something.
Yeah. And it shows up like a marching band.
Right, exactly. You know,
great. Yeah,
absolutely. Good tapping. Good stuff. Yeah. All right, Tam, awesome. How are we doing? I mean, how are we doing? What's cooking? I mean, it sounds like you're doing, I mean, everything's working, but I mean, is there anything you want to look at? I mean, it's interesting that your income is back to where it was a little bit better, which is great.
Yeah.
And means you're kind of meeting your spending plan, or whatever you're calling yourself, budget spending plan, right?
Hey, I have been financially sober over 4 years. I
awesome.
Got that wonderful little book from that you recommended, that Get Out of Debt, Stay Out of Debt, whatever the thing was, and
Jerry Mundis,
yeah, committed to that. And let me tell you, I am so relieved, and it did get kind of, you know, I'm certainly not out of the woods yet. It's going to be a short of a universal little miracle. Things will be kind of tight. I'd like to be able to, you know, to keep my home, and I got some, you know, some anxiety about that, and probably, you know, I don't want to move in the winter. I don't want my kids to have to move while my middle daughter, you know, a couple months before she's she's a senior, you know, and I guess I'd like to somehow get from the fear side of that to the other side of that, where I'm seeing it different. I'm keeping my home. You know what I mean? Like, because I'm really kind of just pinned in this position where I'm full of anxiety about it and a little apprehensive about what will happen. And, mm-hmm. So things are coming along, but I would like to just not be, you know what I think it is? I think if I have to sell my home, then I feel like, you know, that son of a bitch, he won, you know? So I don't, I'm,
Well, let me, it's been a long time since I've been involved with mortgages. I mean, at one time I was actually kind of working as a loan officer a million years ago.
Yeah.
But I know that I'm not quite sure exactly how it works, and I don't even know if it's going to still be on the books. It might still be on the books, but, you know, this was something that Obama cooked up. I don't know if it's any good or not or whether it works, but I know a number of people have taken advantage of it. Wasn't there something on the books where you could meet with the bank and kind of restructure your mortgage, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera?
Yeah, there is a, I would have the option to refinance. Mm-hmm. And probably get in at a lower rate. My goal is to pull out enough equity to pay off the last four unsecured credit loans that I have. Mm. That are probably the tune. It's probably like $12,000, I suppose, total for that. And then I'm not paying any high interest and stuff. So I am looking into that. As a matter of fact, on Friday I picked up an application from a local lender, and I am going to move in that direction. I guess I've had some resistance of necessarily knowing which way to go, a little bit of confusion or, mm-hmm. you know, just that more resistance, not confusion. I mean, I understand the process. If I stepped into it, I know I could figure it out. It's just more of that resistance and that kind of feeling just kind of sick to my stomach and, you know, like,
so there's something kind of frightening about it or something's no, let's yeah. work. Let's look at it. I mean, again, it's just business. It's, you yep. know, it's numbers and either they're going to say yes or they're going to say no, you know?
Right.
When you say you feel sick to your stomach when you think about it, or you have some feelings somewhere about it, yeah. Let's tune in. Let's see where it goes. Okay. Just for fun. Okay. Just want you to tune in.
Just for fun.
Mortgage thing, you know, the refinancing of the house or straightening out your finances, going to the bank or going to a lender. All right. And what's the feeling? You said sick to your stomach or what's the feeling? Go ahead.
Yeah. I feel like I'm losing. Like I've lost something. Like I'm
okay.
You know, like I, it's like something's being taken from me, you know, like okay. I'm losing.
Okay, so even though now you feel like you're losing when you go to the lender, or you feel like you're losing now before you go? I'm confused.
Before I go, like that I would even have to go through that.
Okay.
That I would even have to look at that, yeah.
Okay, so even though I have all this resistance of going to the bank and refinancing my house,
even though I have all this resistance to going to the bank and refinancing my house.
Because it feels like I'm losing.
It feels like I'm losing.
And he's winning.
And he's winning.
And he's laughing at me.
And he's laughing at me.
And I feel all sick to my stomach.
And I feel all sick to my stomach.
But I deeply and completely love, accept, and forgive myself.
Love, accept, and forgive myself.
So even though I feel like a bad little girl.
Bad little boy.
And I failed. I lost. And he's winning. And I don't want to do it. I deeply and completely love, accept, and forgive myself.
Love, accept, and forgive myself.
Top of the head. I don't want to do it.
I want to do it.
All right, bro. You can't make me.
You can't make me.
Sorry, it feels like I'm losing.
And
he's winning.
I
don't know. It's not fair that I have to do this.
It's not fair that I have to do this.
He should do this. Collarbone. But he can't do it.
He can't do it.
He's 5 years old. He can only play with little red choo-choos.
You can only play with little red choo-choos.
Top of the head. I have to take my power back.
You I have to take my power back.
I'm a strong, healthy woman.
I'm a
big girl. I can handle money. I can handle big girl money stuff. And actually, if I handle the big girl money stuff. Collarbone, I'm the winner. And he's the loser. Righty Chop, he's been a loser all along. Top of that, he couldn't handle this stuff. So it's time for me to stop waiting for him to grow up and handle this stuff. Top of that, I have to handle this stuff. It's my life and my house. I have to handle this stuff. I'm a strong, healthy woman. Caliban, I'm a smart, strong, healthy woman. And I know a thing or two. Karate Chop, and I've paid my dues. Top of the head, and I can figure out how to do this. And I have the intelligence and the power to do it. I'm not taking back whatever power I gave him. Because he can't deal with this. He could never deal with this. On the mouth.
I'm going to deal with it.
And I'm a big girl. And I can do big girl stuff. Karate Chop. So even though I've got all this resistance. And dealing with the house financing. Today, right now, I set a firm intention. To let go of all that resistance. And give myself, take my power back. And start dealing with the financing of the house. And I deeply and completely. Love, accept, and forgive myself. Take a deep breath. And now release. Okay, how are we doing?
Much better. Felt a nice shift there. Thank you, Tony.
Yeah, I mean, again, you know, I know the little girl inside you says, I'm not going to do it till he does it. He's supposed to do it. You know? Well, you got a long way, honey. You got a long way. And you can talk to the little girl and say, mommy's in charge and mommy's going to do it, you know. But there's that little girl. And you're like, he didn't do it. I'm not going to do it till he does it. Now it's there. You know.
Oh, got some new stuff for my Matrix tap for sure.
You know
what was so fun about working with Paul is that we were so identical. It was just so easy to really write some really long scripts, you know.
I'm going to call him this week and see what he's doing. I know he's doing, from what I gather, he's doing very well, and maybe he's sort of outgrown us, but I'll see what's going on with him. He sent me a couple of emails and he called me up once, you know, but I'll see what's cooking with him, see what's going on, you know.
Yeah, awesome.
Nice member of the crew. Okay, so we're almost about the top of the hour. I think we've had some fun and we've had a few giggles, but also done some good work, some serious work. William, I think just be open to inspiration and developing that vision of the campsite, and also, as that vision develops, you're going to get the details, but you'll also start seeing synchronicities and, little opportunities and, maybe people are going to start calling you up, offering you land, or people are going to start calling you up saying, where can I camp out? Or, you're going to get all these kind of weird kind of, synchronicities. And then also as the shitty committee and, as these voices come out of your past, write the stuff down and then we'll tap on it. Okay, William?
You bet.
Awesome.
Well, listen, congratulations, Tammy, on the new gig. It sounds great. And just what you ordered, right?
It's just what I ordered.
Awesome. All right, so let's wind up with the abundance tap and call it a night. I want to thank you all for being here. I love you guys. And we'll be here next week, and hopefully I'll be able to drag some of the old crew back in, okay? Or maybe some new people, new faces or voices, okay? Woo-hoo. All righty, so let's rub sore spot or tap in your karate chop. Just repeat after me. Even though I have been allowing the universe...
Even though I have been allowing the universe
to manifest some abundance into my life.
To manifest some abundance into my life.
I set a firm intention. To allow the universe to manifest even more abundance in my life.
To manifest even more abundance in my life.
And I deeply and completely
love, accept, and forgive myself.
So even though I have been allowing the universe
to manifest some abundance in my life.
Today, right now, I set a firm intention.
To allow the universe
to manifest even more abundance in my life. And I deeply and completely. Love, accept, and forgive myself. Excellent. Very good. Let's go karate chop. Today, right now, I set a firm intention. Very good. Top of the head. To allow the universe to manifest even more abundance in my life. Very good. Excellent. Eyebrow. Even more abundance of love. Even more abundance of happiness.
Under
the eye on the cheekbone. Even more abundance of good health. Under the nose. Even more abundance of financial prosperity.
Even more abundance of artistic creativity.
Collarbone. Even more abundance of good friends. Under the arm. Even more abundance of all the good things I really need. Karate chop. So today, right now, I set a firm intention.
So today, right now, I set a firm intention.
Top of the head. To allow the universe to manifest even more abundance in my life. Very good. Eyebrow. Even more abundance of love. Side of the eye. Even more abundance of happiness. On the eye. Even more abundance of good health. Under the nose, even more abundance of financial prosperity. Under the mouth, even more abundance of artistic creativity. Collarbone, even more abundance of good friends. Under the arm, even more abundance of all the good things I really need.
Even more abundance of good things I really need.
Karate chop, and I deeply and completely. Love, accept, and forgive myself. Awesome, very cool. Let's all take a deep breath. And I'll release. Okay, guys, it's a wrap. I want to thank you all for being here tonight and look forward to seeing you next week, next Sunday. But in the meantime, have a wonderful, abundant, happy, healthy, love-filled, we're moving almost into Christmas, aren't we? Almost Christmas. Wow.
Christmas, right.
I know. Have a wonderful, love-filled week and Christmas and all that good smushy stuff. So I love you all. God bless.
God
love you. God bless you, Tony. Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye.